Good afternoon. My name is Cecilia, and I will be your community leader for this Mass. Please stand and welcome our pastor, Father Jerry Hurley. And let us all join together in worship and sing All the Ends of the Earth.
Of the earth, all the creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord, for the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. Break into song all the deeds of the Lord, the one God has done in every age. All the ends of the earth, all the creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. Heaven and earth shall rejoice in his might. Every heart, every nation call the Lord. All the ends of the earth, all the creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. The Lord has made salvation known, faithful to the promises of old. Let the ends of the earth, let the sea and all it holds, make music before our King. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord. For the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And with your spirit.
Thank you. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Welcome to our celebration. And as we begin, we pause once again and we call to mind our need for his forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, The Spirit comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings. And the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will. We know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A responsorial psalm. My hope, O Lord, is in your mercy. Look, answer me, O Lord, my God. Give light to my eyes that I might not sleep in death, lest my enemies say, I have overcome him, lest my foes rejoice at my downfall. My hope,
O Lord,
is in your mercy. Though I trusted in your mercy, let my heart rejoice in your salvation. Let me sing of the Lord. He has been good to me. My hope, in your mercy.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus passed through towns and villages, teaching as he went and making his way toward Jerusalem. Someone asked him, Lord, will only a few people be saved? He answered them, strive to enter through the narrow gate. For many, I tell you, will attempt to enter, but will not be strong enough. After the master of the house has arisen and locked the door, then will you stand outside knocking and saying, Lord, open the door for us? And he will say to you in reply, I do not know where you are from. And you will say, we ate and drank in your company, and you toured in our streets. And then he will say to you, I do not know where you come from. Depart from me, all you evildoers. And there will be wailing and grinding of teeth when you see Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and the prophets in the kingdom of God, and you yourselves cast out. And people will come from the east and the west and from the north and the south and will recline at the table in the kingdom of God. For behold, some are last who will be first, and some are first who will be last. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I guess the responsorial psalm today would summarize well the portent of the readings. My hope, O Lord, is in your mercy. And that's what Paul is talking about, that we do not know how to pray, yet we have expressions of prayer that come from the Spirit that lives within us, and the Spirit himself intercedes on our behalf with inexpressible groanings. And the one who searches our hearts knows the intent of the Spirit and knows what we need. And so the important piece is placing ourselves in his presence and disposing ourselves to his mercy as the responsorial psalm says, my hope is in your mercy, O Lord. Paul goes on to say that great peace again, Romans chapter 8. What a fabulous chapter, you know, coming through the struggles that he deals with at the end of chapter 7, and then to rise up and write Romans 8. You know, who can separate us from the love of God? There's no separating us, because God is working intently and intensely for us to draw us to himself. What we've got to do is surrender to that reality. Because those whom he predestined, he called, and those whom he called, he justified, and those whom he justified, he glorified. Contrast that to the gospel episode, people struggling along with him, Jesus going through the towns and villages, teaching, and all the way making his way to Jerusalem. Difficult challenge for the apostles, because he's teaching them and preparing them for what will unfold when they come to Jerusalem. And so somebody throws out the question, Lord, will only a few people be saved? Never asked again after that, right? Or asked every day after that, perhaps. You know, it's kind of an obsession. Why do we worry about that? Wouldn't we be better engaged in going ahead and trusting the mercy of the Lord and having our faith, my hope, O Lord, is in your mercy? That's what we need to be about, not worrying about who's going to get in and who isn't. It's all the benevolence of the Lord. And indeed, what Paul is saying, we should be praying for all of them, that all of them come to the kingdom of God and all experience the sheer benevolence and bounty of the Lord. And that is certainly the will of the Lord. Although he gives directions to them, try to go through the narrow way and the narrow gate. What is the narrow gate? He summarized it just a few weeks ago again in the gospel. What's the greatest commandment? Love of God and love of neighbor. And they are inseparable. The whole law and the prophets can be summarized in those. And the core issue becomes, do I really act lovingly? My speech, my communications about others, do I speak of others in ways that I would in their presence speak the same way, or do I speak in their presence one way and away apart from them another way? What a great challenge. And Jesus says, hey, that's the narrow way, that we don't be so expansive in giving expression and thought and determinations about other people. We try to limit that and realize, hey, God is working in the assembly. God is working in his people, trying to bring about salvation. And what we've got to do is surrender to him. Lord, my hope is in your mercy. Lord, we ask you to hear our prayers. We gather in your name today.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that we may always be imbued with the true missionary spirit and be given the courage to proclaim the good news and what we say and what we do to the neighbors we know and the neighbors we have not yet met. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders around the world, that they may be committed to the pursuit of justice for all peoples, especially those who are persecuted for their faith, their culture, or their background. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may transform the wastelands of discord, selfishness, and lies to meadows of peace, generosity, and truth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For missionaries who dedicate their lives to bringing Christ's message and love to people all around the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we will follow the example of Jesus, responding to the cries of those in need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our faithful departed brothers and sisters who have died in the hope of rising again, especially Gail Davis, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For all who are sick in our parish community and for all our own relatives and friends who are in need of your healing and saving power, especially Kelly Callion and Valerie McGar, and all others who have asked us to remember them in prayer, we pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who have died in the hope of rising again. We pray especially for the repose of the soul of Bill Burke, the stepfather of Trace Ladner. We ask you, Lord, to reward him with life and bless his family at this time. We pray to you, Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, all of these, our prayers we bring to you, we ask that you accept and grant them, for we offer them with faith in Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread we offer you, the work of human hands who will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands who will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice of ours may be acceptable to God, who is our Almighty Father.
Lord,
accept the sacrifice of my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. And by the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us eternal life. And so we join the angels and saints in proclaiming your glory as we sing. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, and all of your people. And remember all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the apostles and with all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Now we pray for the coming of the kingdom as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always freed from sin and safe from all distress, as we await in blessed hope the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always. Thank you, and let us be grateful for that peace and acknowledge it to one another.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy,
that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
As we receive communion, let us be mindful of receiving the body of Christ, making us living tabernacles. Let us join together in thanksgiving to our Lord and sing the Supper of the Lord.
Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. The Lord prepares a feast divine. Bread of love is broken down, cup of life is poured. Come share the supper of the Lord. Down from heaven, giving life to us, to all the world. Precious body, precious blood, seen as bread and wine. Hear the Lord. The feast divine. Bread of love is broken down, cup of life is poured. Come share the supper of the Lord. I am the living spring of eternal life. He that drinks from me shall not thirst again. Precious body, precious blood, here in bread and the Lord prepares a feast divine. Bread of love is broken down, cup of life is poured. Come share the supper of the Lord.
Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in science we may one day possess in truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God continue to bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended, and we go now in peace to love and to serve God and each other.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you all for being here. Glad you could be with us, and we continue our prayers for each other and for our world.
Adoration will follow immediately after Mass. We will dismiss those who are leaving before the exposition of the Blessed Sacrament. Let us now say our parish commitment prayer, or pray our parish commitment prayer.
Here's my promise, Lord. I commit to look for the face of God in every face I see. I commit to respect and act with empathy and compassion toward all, especially those who are struggling, and those whose beliefs, values, and lifestyles are different from mine. I will do my part to stop the spread of the virus, prejudice, racism, poverty, and negativity. I can only do this through you, with you, and in you, Almighty God. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, amen.
Let us all praise our God together with our closing song, Sing to the Mountains.
Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea, raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made, let all the earth rejoice. I will give thanks to you, my Lord, you have answered my plea. You have saved my soul from death, you are my strength and my song. Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea, raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made, let all the earth rejoice. This is the day that the Lord has made, let us rejoice and be glad. Death has lost and all is life. Sing of the glory of God. Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your hearts. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the